Call the meeting of the city council to order for Thursday evening, December 27, 2018. Stand as we salute our American flag. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Good evening, councils. Good evening, guests. Merry belated Christmas, and we're on our way to a happy new year. Let's all hope and pray. Councilor Derenkut, did you?
Thank you, Mr. President. It is truly unfortunate to mention that the Mayoyo family, they know by O'Willis family, they have a store in Ward 7, and I believe this is Councilor Shelley Azak Ward. Unfortunately, on Christmas Day, the house got on fire, and two of them died. And I know Mayoyo pretty well. He was a wonderful man, and they still have a store in Brockton on Oak Street, so it's very unfortunate. So I would like to ask for a moment of silence for him and also his son, who is 28 years old, that died by trying to save his father. So thank you.
Definitely.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. First item on the agenda.
The acceptance of the minutes of December 10th, 2018, City Council meeting.
Accepted and placed on file. Council.
I'd like to take number two collectively and act on the suspension rules so we can vote on it tonight.
I'd say number two and three.
Yes.
Collectively, we're going to act on them this evening. All in favor of that? Opposed? Mr. Clerk, please read items two and three.
Promotion of firefighter James B. Campbell to the rank of fire lieutenant in the Brockton Fire Department. Promotion of fire lieutenant Eric J. Nardelli to the rank of fire captain in the Brockton Fire Department.
Madam Clerk, would you please call the roll for appointment?
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Derenkut?
Yes.
Ianieri?
Yes.
Farwell?
Yes.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
Yes.
Nicastro?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
That's 11 in the affirmative.
And they are both confirmed, and I believe they are both here because I invited them, Lieutenant Campbell and Captain Nardelli. Congratulations, gentlemen. What a nice Christmas gift, right? There you go. Congratulations. I'm sure you're doing an outstanding job, as you've been doing for the last several years, and keeping us safe. So good luck. Best wishes to you. Next item, Madam Clerk. Mr. Clerk.
You want to call a recess? They want to clear
out. If you want to, we'll take a
two-minute
recess.
In the past.
Call the meeting back into order. Councilor Sullivan.
A motion for reconsideration, hopes it doesn't prevail for number two and three.
Motion been made and seconded for reconsideration, hopes it did not prevail on items two and three. All in favor of reconsideration? All opposed? Reconsideration fails. You're welcome. Next item, Mr. Clerk.
On the very quickly, on the hearings on the garage, motor vehicle license. Number four. We have the appointment of Tanya Tillman of 1092 North Main Street, Brockton, to the Election Commission for a term of 4 years.
Referred to the Committee on Finance.
We have the appointment of Jane Parker of 46 Lydia Avenue, Brockton, to the Election Commission for a term of 4 years.
Referred to the Committee on Finance.
We have the appointment of Eugene S. Merrill of 128 Healy Terrace, Brockton, as an alternate to the Brockton License Commission for a term of 3 years.
Referred to the Committee on Finance.
We have the appointment of Donald Dobbins, 21 Hemlock Street, Brockton, as the Constable in the City of Brockton for a term of 3 years.
Referred to the Committee on Finance.
We have a hearing. The petition of Walmart Real Estate Business Trust in connection with a proposed Cumberland Farms Incorporated retail gas station. CO Smollett Lawn LLP, East Mill, 21 High Street, Suite 301 North Andover, Mass. 01845 ZIP for an underground storage, flammable storage license located at 700 Oak Street, Brockton, Mass.
Time having arrived, I declare the hearing open. If there is anyone here present in favor of, I ask them to please come up and speak to the mic. The mic's over there. The mic travels like the city council does. We don't know where we... There we are.
Yes.
How are you? Good evening, John.
Good evening.
Good evening.
John Smolak, attorney from Walmart Real Estate Business Trust. I'm a bit relieved that the crowd wasn't here for my hearing. So, certainly, as had been mentioned, Walmart is the owner and applicant with respect to this Flambeau's license. Walmart is proposing to lease a 2-acre portion of a 14-acre parcel of land at 700 Oak Street to Cumberland Farms for the purposes of operating a retail gasoline station and convenience store. Very similar to the three other stores that Cumberland Farms has proposed to the city and has the city has approved back on in connection with 306 Main Street, 1813 Main Street, and most recently 1205 Belmont Street. And so this is a very similar request as those other requests, and we've received all of our approvals from the Board of Appeals back in August, Planning Board approval this early December, as well as Conservation Commission approval back in October of this year. So we're requesting the council's approval for this license.
Very good. Thank you, John. Anyone else here in favor of Councilor Azak?
Thank you, Mr. President. I would just like to state that I had been at the zoning meeting, at the original, the first zoning meeting. There were some constituents that lived in Madrid Square that had many concerns, and I have to state that the concerns that they had, Cumberland Farms addressed them. They did make the changes. One of the largest concerns was the multiple entrances onto Oak Street, and I was happy to see at the last planning meeting that Cumberland Farms had made the changes. And so they're listening to our residents, which is very important to us, and they've been very easy to work with. They've stayed in contact with us. We've been in constant contact back and forth with the concerns that the community might have, and I appreciate that. So I thank the attorney. Thank you very much. And I haven't received any recent calls regarding any issues, so thank you.
Very good. Anyone else who wants to be heard in favor of? Please come forward and state your name to the clerk. Anyone else here in favor of? Seeing none, I declare that part of the hearing closed. Anybody here in opposition? Anybody here in opposition? Please come forward and state your name to the clerk. Seeing none, I declare that part of the hearing closed. At this time, I would ask for a motion.
Recommend favorably to the full city council.
Motion made and seconded to recommend favorably to the full city council.
We are.
Motion recommend
to approve the grant.
Motion.
Yeah, it'll be motion granted, right. I didn't forget. Motion to grant was what I was going to say next, but everyone's working ahead of me tonight, so that's fine. So the motion is to grant. All in favor? Opposed? Duly granted. And if I'm not mistaken, I think with one of the emails that I got from you, it looks like you're going to be starting both, even Belmont, even the one I have in Ward 3 at Belmont and Pearl, around March. And
that's the current schedule.
Current schedule of it, right. Great. Super.
Yes.
President.
Councilor Sullivan.
Relative to this matter, what you mentioned in Ward 3, I believe we asked the attorney and we received it, certificate of insurance for
right.
Ward 3. I'd like to respectfully ask the same for the Ward 7 property.
Okay.
Yes,
that's fine.
And you can just send it like you did last time to the clerk's office. Thank
sure.
you very much, attorney.
Sure.
Thank you.
Mr. President, I just want to
yes,
mention,
John.
Too, the in terms of, again, this is the fourth store that we permitted through the city's Department of Planning and Economic Development. I just want to say that the staff here has been wonderful to work with, and they've been a pleasure to work with, and they're detail-oriented, and they get it. And just want to say that the city is well-served by that department and that staff. So I want to thank you.
Great. And we thank you for keeping your interest right here in the city of Brockton as well. We really do. Thank you very much as well.
Thank you.
Next item, Mr. Clerk.
Petition of Daniel Gill Jr. of 531 Summer Street, East Bridgewater, Mass. For a garage license located at 12 Riverside Avenue, Brockton.
Councilor Nicastro.
I'd like to make a motion to take number 9 and 10 together, please.
Second.
Motion been made and seconded. We take 9 and 10 collectively. All in favor? Opposed? Mr. Clerk, you can
Petition
also read number 10.
L&L Auto Repair, Armando Mendez, 17 Myrtle Avenue, Braintree, Mass. For motor vehicle repair body license located at 12 Riverside Avenue, Boston.
They're going to public safety. But it's the same address.
Right.
two separate people.
No, there's a, in order to go for the repair license, you have to have a garage license at that location first, so that we have a petition from the owner of the property for a garage license, and then we have a petition from the renter for a repair license. The council in that ward apparently has had a discussion with these people, and they want to postpone this hearing until the next council meeting, or refer it to public safety.
No, I agree with the council, though, this numbering, because they're two separate entities, and they're basically two separate items, one that's actually talking about a garage license, and the other one that's talking about a repair shop, whether or not we should take them separate.
You cannot, you don't have to, you can take them together. You cannot issue a body shop license without the garage license being granted first. Now, if there's a question there on maybe something to do with the petition for the garage license as well as the body shop license, it's better that they're both heard at the same time rather than set up two different.
That was just the procedural call. Yeah. That's basically
okay,
it.
Okay, but this procedure is as it should be. You could take them both together. So, as long as you move the garage license first when it comes to that point. Okay.
I second that motion.
Thank you very much. Right. We didn't vote.
No, we didn't. So motion was made and seconded to refer them to the Committee on Public Safety.
I was about to say that, yes. The reason I'm taking them together is because they both have to do with the same property. And the applicant who proposes to run a repair business there needs the garage license as well, which has been applied for by the owner of the property. This man rents. I've met with Mr. Mendez. He's a good guy. He's trying hard. There are some deficiencies in his application, and so I prefer to postpone it until the next council meeting. I'd like it to be heard by the public safety committee, just to vet out and to get the missing information put together, so that when he returns to the council, it's a complete application and we can act on it.
Mr. President.
Councilor Sullivan.
I hear what the council is saying, but I don't believe you can postpone a matter and refer it at the same time. You can't do that.
The postponement would be to an upcoming date.
Right. Well, maybe I misunderstood. I thought you wanted to be postponed and then also referred to public safety. Is that what you said?
I think there might be some.
Has to be postponed.
Yeah.
You can't have both. So.
I think there's some confusion
okay.
here.
Okay. It's postponed until the next.
The hearing.
And then it would be public safety. All right. I got you.
Go to public safety.
Thank you.
After that.
Okay. Motion's been made and seconded that we postpone. All in favor of that? Opposed? Now the motion will be made that we send it to public safety. Am I correct?
No.
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 It's just coming.
Just the way it is.
Okay, fine. Okay. Super. Only two more to go. Yeah, amen.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
Everyone else can run the show now.
Yeah, so there's a meet the space show in heaven.
I'm not going to be around as many years as you, trust me.
Okay, we have the report of the Public Safety Committee for its meeting of December 17th, 2018.
Accepted and placed on file.
The meeting of the Finance Committee for its meeting of December 17th, 2018.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the Chief of the Fire Department requesting a transfer from the other contract service account for $40,000 to the overtime account. This money was budgeted for active shooter response training and equipment. The money was paid from regular overtime account to cover active shooter response training drills in November. The money has been budgeted in line item number 4 in the budget of fiscal 2019.
Accepted and placed on file.
Mayor recommends the same.
Accepted and placed on file. Excuse me. Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the city auditor certifying the balance of the stabilization fund as of December 12, 2018 is $4,726,629.99.
Accepted and placed on file.
From the mayor, in accordance with Mass General laws, recommending that the city council authorize a total appropriation of $165,000 from the stabilization fund to the law department property purchase for the acquisition of 34 Quarter Street property. It is intended that this property will be for the benefit of the Council on Aging.
Accepted and placed on file.
From the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
From the mayor stating that it's recommended by the study by the College Center of UMass Boston in order to establish a salary structure for the new position of Assistant Human Resources Director, which is commensurate with the responsibilities and duties of the title. Employment Specialist, hereby recommending, and as requested by the Director of Human Resources, Sandra Knight, that the revised ordinance of the city, Section 2-127, pay plan, be amended by added to compensation grade DA/P-2. This classification carries 8 steps, ranging from $63,887 to $95,467. It is currently contains the titles of Assistant Auditor, Assistant Treasurer/Collector, and Budget Director.
Accepted and placed on file.
The mayor recommended the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
And the mayor stating that in order to establish a salary structure for the new position of Assistant Human Resource Director, which is commensurate with responsibilities and duties of the title, hereby recommends that revised ordinances of the city, Section 2-127 plan, be amended by adding Assistant Human Resource Director to DA/P-1, same classification as Financial Analyst and Assistant Clerk.
Accepted and placed on file.
From the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the Emergency Management Director requesting authorization to accept and expend Fiscal 18-19 Hazardous Material Emergency Preparedness Grant in the amount of $1,750. This funding will be used to purchase office equipment and supplies to assist with emergency planning. No match is required.
Accepted and placed on file.
The mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the Emergency Management Director requesting authorization to accept and expend Fiscal 18 Emergency Management Planning Grant in the amount of $20,460. This funding will be used to purchase a new 2019 Ford F-250 or equivalent, match of $19,536.50 is required.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommended.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the Superintendent of Parks requesting authorization to accept and expend an appropriation of $75,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts for improvements to the Lyndon C. Nelson Playground.
Accepted and placed on file.
The mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
From the DPW Commissioner requesting that the City Council accepts monies awarded in the amount of $52,000 from the Mass Environmental Protection Sustainable Materials Recovery Program Municipal Grant to Department of Public Works Sustainable Materials Recovery Program Municipal Grant Program. This grant will be used to defray the cost of purchasing 96-gallon wheel containers for the new curbside single-stream recycling program.
Accepted and placed on file.
Mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
All relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Chief of Police requested that the City Council authorization to expend initial grant monies in the amount of $3,360.02 from the Executive Office of Public Safety and Security Office of Grants and Reserve Highway Safety Division, Fiscal 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program to the City of Brockton Police Department, Fiscal 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program Fund.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the Assistant City Auditor certifying that the balance of the ambulance receipts reserve for appropriation as of December 18, 2018 is $297,335.93.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the Fire Chief requested that the City Council authorize a transfer at the amount of $131,900 from ambulance receipts to Fire Department purchase of services in order to purchase EMS coats, a vehicle for Fire Department Signal Division, to replace the aging dispatch computers and fire alarm, mobile computers, two-way radios, portable radios, and to maintain connection to Comcast between fire alarms and EMS stations and to improve portable radio programming upgrades.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the police chief requesting that the City Council authorized to accept a donation of 18 car seats valued at $3,497.40 from the Executive Office of Public Safety and Security. fiscal 2019 Child Passenger Safety Equipment Grant to City of Brockton Police Department, fiscal 2019 Child Passenger Safety Equipment Grant Fund.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the superintendent of parks requesting that the city council authorize the acceptance and expenditures of an appropriation in the amount of $150,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation to City of Brockton Parks Department in order to improve the Harold B. Bent Playground.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have a communication from the superintendent of parks requesting that the city council authorize the appropriation in the amount of $75,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation to City of Brockton Parks Department in order to improve the Danny Goodwin Playground.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the mayor recommending the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
Communication from the CFO relative to the same.
Accepted and placed on file.
We have an ordinance to establish licensing and regulations for adult use marijuana establishments, favorably as amended in City Council December 10, 2018, passed with third reading as amended in City Council June 25, 2018, read and referred to Standing Committee on Ordinances. That report was favorable as amended in City Council December 10, 2018, passed with third reading as amended.
Questions on voting on a final passage by a roll call vote. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
No.
Cruz?
Yes.
Davenport?
Yes.
Ianieri?
Yes.
Farwell?
Yes.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
Yes.
Nicastro?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
That's 10 in the affirmative, 1 in the negative.
The order is adopted.
President, move for reconsideration.
Hopes does not prevail.
Motion been made and seconded for reconsideration. Hopes it does not prevail. All in favor of reconsideration? All opposed? Reconsideration fails.
Petition of Eddie A1, DBA A1 Restorations for Motor Vehicle Mechanical Repair License located at 287 North Montel Street, Unit 1, in Council November 26, 2018. Ready for the Standing Committee on Public Safety. That report was favorable.
The question is on adoption by roll call vote. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Davenport?
Yes.
Ianieri?
Yes.
Farwell?
Yes.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
Yes.
Nicastro?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
Petition of Eddie A1, DBA A3 Motor Works for Motor Vehicle Mechanical Repair License located at 287 North Montel Street, Unit 3, in Council November 26, 2018. Ready to refer to Standing Committee on Public Safety. That report was unfavorable.
President.
Questions? Councilor Fowler.
I'd like to move to take, 53 and 54 collectively and speak
second.
On them.
Second.
Motion made and seconded. We take item 53 and 54 collectively. All in favor of that? Opposed? Take them collectively.
Petition.
President and members of the council, the Public Safety Committee met on the 17th of December with respect to the applications of Mr. Awan, who filed before September 1st, so he was properly before the council in terms of requesting a motor vehicle repair license, and he requested three additional licenses for that address. We already have three motor vehicle repair or motor vehicle mechanical licenses issued there. Quick and Clean Auto Care, which has a license that expires on April 30th, 2019. We have ETA Automotive Repairs, which has a license that expires on April 30th, 2019. And we have M Style Motorsports, which expires on April 30th, 2019. From the information that we received from Mr. Awan, basically he has tenants at that address and they want to expand into other bays. However, rather than have them come in and ask for a modification of their license, he wants licenses issued so that if my memory serves, if those businesses were to leave, he would control licenses for all of those bays. So the issue comes down to basically what's best for the community, what's fair to Mr. Awan. I always have a problem having one address which is taxed as one building and having six licenses. I mean, I don't know of a building in this city that has six Dunkin' Donuts side by side or six pizza parlors side by side. What could he do with the licenses? Well, they are tangible property. They can be sold. You could say to someone, Tim Cruise, if you want to open up in one of my bays, I'll lease you the property or I'll rent you the property, and I have a license which I can transfer to you for a fee. Nothing illegal about that, perfectly proper. But on a 2-2 tie vote, the subcommittee, the Public Safety Subcommittee, did not recommend the additional two licenses. I can only speak for myself. I think it's saturating that area with motor vehicle repair licenses. I think that if the businesses at that location want to expand, they can certainly come in and ask to have their license modified. But I don't see where the public good is served by having six licenses on that piece of property, with the traffic coming and going, with the parking that will be obviously required. If it's more than 15 cars, we have ordinances that require handicap parking. For employees, for example, I mean, just think about six different businesses operating in that piece of property. You're obviously going to have parking for your employees. So for all of those reasons, I am not in favor and will not vote for the other two, but I just wanted all of you to know the background that we did give this a pretty thorough vetting. I think it went about an hour and 5 minutes. And obviously there are people in favor, there are people opposed, but that's where I'm coming from as a member of the Public Safety Committee and as a counselor at large. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you, Counselor. Your notes, we read number 53, I believe, so you're going to we'll read number 54 and then we'll take a vote.
Petition of Eddie A1 DBA, A4 Automotive, for a motor vehicle mechanical repair license located at 287 North Montello Street, Unit 4, and Council November 26, 2018. Read and referred to the Standing Committee on Public Safety. That report was unfavorable.
The question now is an adoption by roll call vote. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
No.
Cruz?
No.
Darrincourt?
Yes.
Ianieri?
No.
Farwell?
No.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
No.
Nicastro?
No.
Rodriguez?
No.
Sullivan?
No.
That's 8 in the negative and only 3 in the affirmative.
It fails of adoption.
Consideration that it not prevail.
Motion been made and seconded for reconsideration in hopes it does not prevail. All in favor of reconsideration? Opposed to reconsideration? Consideration fails.
Order that the City Council authorizes the acceptance and expenditures of the total grant funds, any amount of $98,469 from the Community IT Grant, the City of Brockton, in conjunction with the Brockton Public School District, intends on expanding the capacity of the public safety network, which is a dedicated fiber network to deliver all things related to public safety. In Council, December 10, 2018. Read and refer to the Standing Committee on Finance. That report was favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Darrincourt?
Yes.
Ianieri?
Yes.
Farwell?
Yes.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
Yes.
Nicastro?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
Resolved to invite the Mass Department TDI Fellow to inform the City Council as the results of the Summer Beer Garden project known as PROBA and any future plans for other such activity. In Council, November 26, 2018, ready with the Standing Committee on Finance, that report was favorable.
Questions on adoption by roll call vote. Madam Clerk, please call the roll.
Asak?
Yes.
Beauregard?
Yes.
Cruz?
Yes.
Darrincourt?
Yes.
Ianieri?
Yes.
Farwell?
Yes.
Lally?
Yes.
Monahan?
Yes.
Nicastro?
Yes.
Rodriguez?
Yes.
Sullivan?
Yes.
That's 11 in the affirmative.
The order is adopted.
An audit submitting Section 2-127 pay plan of the revised auditors of the City of Brockton be ordained as follows. Section 2-127 pay plan is hereby amended by adding to compensation grade DA/P-2.
Referred to planning and ordinance.
and ordinance amending Section 2-127 pay plan of the revised ordinances of the City of Brockton. Be it ordained that the revised ordinances of the City, Section 2-127 pay plan, be amended by adding Assistant Human Resources Director to DA/P1.
Referred to Planning and Ordinance.
Total transfer of $40,000 from the Fire Department Purchase of Services to Fire Department Overtime.
Referred to Finance.
President, yep. Just had a question relative to 57 and 58. I believe those would just go to ordinance. They don't deal with zoning, so they shouldn't go to planning.
No zoning, yeah. Well, I'm only following what somebody typed here for me, so. Yep.
Thank you.
The 40,000 referred to Finance.
We're going to
60.
The total appropriation of $165,000 from the Stabilization Fund, $165,000, to Law Department Property Purchase.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation of the total grant funds in the amount of $1,750 from the Mass Emergency Management Agency, the City of Brockton Emergency Management Agency, Fiscal 18-19 Hazardous Material Emergency Preparedness Grant Fund.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation of the total grant funds in the amount of
Council Beauregard.
I'm sorry. Can we take that under the suspension of rules for the
17th? No, I'm sending everything to Finance.
Okay.
An appropriation of the total grant funds in the amount of $20,460 from Mass Emergency Management Agency, the City of Brockton Emergency Management Agency, Fiscal 18 Emergency Management Planning Grant Fund. There is a match required in the amount of $19,536.50 from Stabilization Fund, $19,536.50 to Emergency Management Fiscal 18 Planning Grant Fund.
Referred to Finance.
Appropriation of total grant in the amount of $52,000 from the Mass Environmental Protection Sustainable Materials Recovery Program Municipal Grant to Department of Public Works Sustainable Materials Recovery Program Municipal Grant Program.
Referred to Finance.
Appropriation of the total grant in the amount of $3,360.02 from the Executive Office of Public Safety and Security Office of Grants and Research Highway Safety Division Fiscal 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program, the City of Brockton Police Department, Fiscal 19 Traffic Enforcement and Equipment Grant Program Fund.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation of the total grant in the amount of $3,497.40 in the form of 18 car seats from Executive Office of Public Safety and Security, Fiscal 2019 Child Passenger Safety Equipment Grant to City of Brockton Police Department, Fiscal 2019 Child Passenger Safety Equipment Grant Fund.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation of $75,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation to the City of Brockton Parks Department.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation in the amount of $150,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation to the City of Brockton Parks Department.
Referred to Finance.
An appropriation in the amount of $75,000 from the Commonwealth of Massachusetts Department of Conservation and Recreation to the City of Brockton Parks Department.
Referred to Finance.
A transfer in the amount of $131,900 from ambulance receipts to Fire Department Purchase Services.
Referred to Finance.
All items on the agenda are available in their entirety for review in the City Clerk's office for all interested parties.
Late file, Councilor.
President, I do have a late file just for those that don't sit on the Ordinance Committee. Again, it's I chair it, Councilor Falwell, Councilor Monahan, Councilor Cruz, Councilor Rodriguez. We met on the 18th, dedicated again to the issue of recreational marijuana. We met 8 times this year. We did amend it and send it back to the Council. It was the 18th, and then with Christmas, the deadline wasn't met. I decided to file a late file because under Massachusetts General Law, Chapter 48 zoning, it has to go back to Planning Board so that under MGL they can give a recommendation to the council before we do a final vote. As you know, this body extended the moratorium until the end of January. So if we do a late file tonight and it's referred to planning, it gets the ball rolling so that we keep on track for January. So that's the purpose of my late file, councilors.
Motion made and second to accept the late file. All in favor? Opposed? Mr. Clerk, I believe you have the late file.
Okay, the first late file relative to that would be the report of the Audits Committee's meeting for December 18, 2018. So if you accept that.
Accept that?
That's accepted.
Yeah, we're accepted, right?
Yeah. And then the acceptance of the ordinance, an ordinance amending Chapter 27 of the revised ordinances of the City of Brockton concerning the regulations and taxation of marijuana.
And your motion?
A motion is to refer that to the Planning Board.
Okay.
President.
Okay. Motion made and seconded to refer to the Planning Board. All in favor of that? Opposed? Goes to the Planning Board.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Yep. Councilors, before we go any further, I misstepped. I opened my mouth before I should have. Sometimes I do that. That's okay. I get criticized for enough things. But in any case, there will be a finance meeting on January the 7th. Unfortunately, because we have so many items here, and there's items here that are very questionable. Even the chief indicated to me, fire chief was here and wanted to talk about three or four items that he has here. So, in any case, we will be here next Monday, the 7th, at 7 o'clock p.m. I've already spoken to the auditor's office and to Aaron, and we already have it set up so that things should get out in a timely fashion. I know the clerk's office always works fast and furious. I'm sure Robin will get everything upstairs by mid-afternoon or the latest Monday morning anyways, so they'll have everything up in the auditor's office so they'll be able to work and put in the meeting together. I'm sure that'll happen. So that's when we'll have everything out in time. So it's January the 7th will be the finance meeting. The other thing I just want to make mention to you, because people keep questioning, elevator is still, it's got a hiccup. So it's probably going to have a hiccup. Could have a hiccup till the end of January, could have a hiccup till the beginning of February. But as they keep going up higher, we keep running into problems. So I've already booked here for the whole month of January. No matter who the next president may be, I've already taken care of that. And then again on January 14th there'll be a council meeting here as well. So that's all I have to say at this point. Councilor Sullivan.
In regards to tradition of the council, so it's the last council meeting of the year. On behalf of the council, we want to thank you for your presidency and your leadership this year.
Thank you. Appreciate it very much. I will be conducting the finance meeting, and then everything will switch over in January 14th. So I do appreciate that. It was a challenging year on my behalf too. Sometimes I wish I was a little bit stronger, and I think things would have ran a little bit differently. And I just hope that when we get into 2019, that we can all start to come together collectively as a group, and work together in the best interest of the city. I know everybody likes to listen to all the people that they talk to, but sometimes you got to do what the heart tells you to. You really do. That's a part of politics. Do what the heart tells you, and do what you think you have to do in your good conscience. But we got to get away from our division, and we have a little bit of a division. But that'll be my spiel. So see, I got that out of the way now. You won't have to hear from me on that again. But the finance meeting, again, don't forget the finance meeting, please. Councilor Fowler.
Yes. In government and in life, I've always found that a sense of humor can sometimes trump any trials and tribulations that we may have.
What word did you use first?
Trials and tribulations.
Trump.
Oh, okay. No, you didn't.
Oh, Trump. Yes, Trump. That's the non-political Trump.
Okay.
Now,
Councilor, you just got tweeted to.
Councilor Sullivan has really worked hard this past year with all of this marijuana legislation. And I thought, what could I get him? I mean, he has everything. He's got his law degree. He's got a wonderful family. He's got three wonderful children, a wonderful wife. He's,
Bong can fit in that.
He's got it all together. So I thought to myself, what is the one thing that I could get him that he could put into his law office that would memorialize this past year of all of the marijuana legislation? So I thought long and hard, and I came up with your very own Cheech and Chong Up and Smoke coffee mug. So every morning when you hoist this, you will think of all of the meetings that you had and all of the work that you did.
Thank you, Counselor.
And it's one of a kind. No one else is getting one, just you.
This is great. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, Counselor. It's a high point of his career.
Thank you, Counselor.
Anyone else have any?
Under $49.
So we didn't, no ethics law violation or anything, so.
Thank you.
Does anyone else have anything else to come before us? We'll be here on the FinCom on January the 7th. Seeing none at this time, that we will conclude the meeting, and we'll go into a caucus.